My name is Rhapsody, and welcome back to Hearthstone Tavern Brawl. Week 14 or something similar? I want to say 13 or 14 or... I never want to interrupt the innkeeper while he's saying that. There is a new set of crazy rules this week. That's right, Underdog rules. Each turn, if you're losing by more than 3 health, then a random minion rallies. I think I was going for allies. Rallies to your side. So, there was a little bit of discussion on the Hearthstone subreddit a few weeks ago, not recently. I didn't want to check out and see what the meta was going to be. I like to figure that out myself. But there was a lot of discussion about there being a game mode where you would win if you were losing, right? Like, exhaust yourself to zero health faster than your opponent, which this kind of is similar to. You want to get your health as low as possible. And the discussions were basically that Warlock would be the best class for that. I mean, obviously, your hero power takes 2 life from you. You summon minions that deal damage to you, like double flame imp deals damage to you. Double Wrathguard. Whenever this minion takes damage, you also deal that much damage to your hero. Pit Lord. Yes. Deal 5 damage to your hero. Floating Watcher might be actually pretty good because you want to deal damage to your hero on your turn. Dread Infernal will deal damage to yourself as well. Yeah, I'll put it in just for funsies. And I guess just to make this deck a little more viable, I'll also put in Void Callers. You know what? I'll craft a Pit Lord for it. I'll jump on that dagger. Jump on that grenade, rather. Pit Lord. For kids. Is there anything else that I could take that's gonna actively damage me? Oh, that's interesting. So your opponent's gonna want to do the same, so Zombie Chow is gonna be really important, because then you can heal your opponent. Doesn't really look like there's a great amount of options for the rest of this. I don't want to deal any damage to my opponent, if at all possible. But I do want to heal them. You know what, I'll put in Earthen Ring Farseer, where's that? Earthen Ring Farseer. Any more things for healing? Mind Control Tech, I'll put double Mind Control Tech in, just because if your opponent is getting ahead of you, you might be able to Mind Control Tech, take one of theirs. You might be able to even things out a little bit with the Mind Control Tech play there. I'm tempted to take the Bounce Masters so that I can bounce horrible effects like Flame Imp, like Pit Lord, like Earthen Ring Farseer. You know what? Maybe I do that. So the way that I would do that is I'll put in double Voodoo and then go over and also put in... Where are you, Bounce Master? Bounce Master, whoa! Oh, of course, the last page. Then old Bounce Master. There you are. And then things that just burst your opponent down. Right, so if you've got an advantage, now you want to be able to use that advantage to win. So Enhancer Meccano, which I'll just get a second of, because fuck it, why wouldn't I get a second of it? YOLO, bitch! I don't like using that word. Okay, where are you? Enhancer Meccano, create. Excellent. I definitely don't want to put up Taunt because I want to force my opponent to hit my face as often as possible. I definitely don't want Jeeves because I'm going to be life tapping as often as possible. Restore 4 health to each hero is, on average, not going to help me. Silence my minions. No. Antique Healbot, definitely fucking not. There's not that much that left that needs to go into this deck. Probably some spells. Maybe just some spells for controlling the board. Yeah, it seems like a relatively good idea. Ooh, Mukla's Champion I'm kind of interested in as well. You know what, I'll the fucking Mukla's Champion this deck. Okay, let's go back to the Warlock area. Probably gonna need some spells in here for removal. And like, reaching for lethal. Okay, let's take out the things that don't look like great ideas in this deck. So let's check out our curve. Our curve's okay, but it bounces on four. I'll take out the Ancient Brewmasters. They're not doing enough. I'll put in double Power Overwhelming. I'm tempted to put in double Soulfire, but I might just put double Dark Bomb in instead. Yeah, I don't really want to give up any of these cards. Double Dark Bomb. Okay. So this deck is about dealing damage to myself and healing my opponent. And if it gets out of control for them, I get to bring it back to my side. If it gets out of control for me, I've got Floating Watcher and Mookless Champion that'll just go absolutely apeshit on this board. Let's brawl. Boom! So, the most important thing about this brawl that I can see is that you really need to know when to switch from building a board to using your board to kill your opponent, right? You need to know exactly the moment that you have enough momentum to finish the game, and then not be scared of summoning minions for your opponent and just continue going for face. Because you can't just keep losing life the entire game, otherwise you lose. Warlock, obviously. Of course there's going to be Warlock. I don't have a 1-drop, so I'll keep the Wrathguard and I'll toss 2 back. I have 6 1-drops in my deck. Didn't I? Could have sworn I tossed those back.
I greet you. I greet you.
If he summons a Flame Imp, he's going to get a random minion. That's pretty bad for me. I'll actually play this instead of the Wrathguard to stop my opponent from getting a random minion. Because it's at the start of their turn, as I understand it. There's two things that I wanted to check out. Does it trigger at the start of their turn? Or at the end of their turn? Obviously, it triggers at the start. And... I'll just do this. That's fine. And does armor count? Right? Can you go down to 1 health and have 50 armor and just constantly be getting the minions? No. Armor counts as health for this. If I get a decent 2-drop, this could be okay. So I run myself into that, I end up taking 3 damage to my face, I go down to 24, and then I Hero Power, I go down to 22, which puts me 3 below my opponent, which means they are forced to life tap. Okay. I'm really hoping for a really good 3-drop. Sorry, 2-drop. Okay. They have to life tap or heal me in order to not let me summon a minion. Man, I like this mode already. It's got a lot of mind gamesy stuff in it. Like, do I develop my best minion or do I try and stop them from developing their best? It's good for me. What? But I'm losing by... Huh? I'm not okay with that. I was losing by 3 health. Is it more than 3 health? I was 22. They were 25. Is it more than 3 health you have to be losing by? Okay, so they've got 2 tiny Knights of Evil, so I have to assume they've got things in their deck like Dark Bargain, like Soulfire, like... Ooh. That's not a Dark Bargain, is it? It's definitely not a Siphons. Ooh, Doomguard. Oh, there goes Dr. Boom. Dr. Boomguard, sorry. Ooh, Power Overwhelming. That's a lot of damage. Okay, I finally got a fucking minion. Thank you. And it's actually really good right now. I could attack the face, but unfortunately this guy is sleeping. So they lost a Soulfire and a Dr. Boom. That's pretty good for me. They've probably got a lot of, like, burst in their hand.
Regret this. You will regret this.
Excuse me.
Sorry.
Tempted to just mind control tech and enhancer. Get as many mind control buffs as I can. Because I don't want to watching Floater tap. Then I attack. Watching Floater tap attack. Puts me down. Gets my Void Caller on the field. Puts me down to 10. My opponent has... How likely is it they have 6 burst damage considering they've already used a... They've already lost a Soulfire and used a Power Overwhelming. It's relatively likely. Right. It's not unlikely. So I'll go with this play instead. Basically, I'm hoping this gets taunt. I can actually drop them a little lower now. That's fine by me. Oh, that was wrong. Yeah, that was wrong. I didn't want to do the final attack there. It's actually stopped me from summoning another minion. That was my fault. Looks like it didn't make a difference, ultimately. If they can't do anything, then I can just power up a woman and win the game. Molten Giant seems pretty important in this setup. Are you now looking for a taunt? Fist of Jiraxxus. Fine. Well played! Too easy! Oh, you goddamn nerd. Okay, so it looks like this deck construction is relatively common, right? First person I played had almost the same deck that I do. I think that the things that might set my deck apart from many other decks are the Mukla's Champions and the Enhancer Mechanos, right? So the ability to go, okay, I've got enough of the board, now fuck you. Ultimately, it didn't matter that I attacked with Kobold. Shit, yes. Reversing a Shaman. Now that's interesting. What do you do as a Doomhammer? But that's turn 5. So what is it you do as a Shaman that other classes won't be able to deal with? I don't know. I think I'm probably going to tap and then tap Molten Giant. Molten Giant. Tap Zombie Chow the turn after. That's pretty good. It's pretty good. Do I even bother attacking? Yeah, worst case scenario, they attack there and then... Oh, but... I'll still attack. See, it's weird, because you kind of want to fight heavily for board control, because you don't want to go face yet. But at the same time, you really don't want to fight for board control either. Luckily, they can't summon a thingy this turn. You know what I mean. A thingy... Okay, they want to heal. They want to trigger this heal while they're on full health. Alright, so I'm going to get a minion this turn. That's good for me. I'll probably have to play the mind control on curve. Oh, what? I'm not going to get a minion. I'm not losing by more than 3 health. Fucker. Get healed on, bitch. Get healed on. I'm not really getting amazing opening hands. Well, let's... No, a 1 into a 1 into a 1 for 2 into a 3 into a 4. I've got pretty good opening hands. I can't complain.
It's clobbering
time. It's clobbering time.
From the void I come.
Okay, So my opponent can take 4 damage to their own face this turn if they wish by using a weapon. Which puts them down to... Nope. I'm still in the lead. Yay! In terms of taking damage. Oh, you know what it is. You know what it is. I'm picking up on what they're fucking putting down right here. I know what it is. Do you know? I know what it is. What they have is a shitload of spells in their deck to burst someone like me down who's doing this kind of a thing. Okay, so if I miss, I want to hit a 1-1, so... Never mind, didn't miss. 100% accurate. Yeah, they'll have a shitload of spells in their deck. Oh! Don't mind if I do. So that while I'm putting myself lower on life, they're just waiting. And then they destroy me in a single swing. It's also probably going to have a significant amount of board clear, so I wouldn't be surprised to see Elemental Destruction or Lightning Storm. These are the guesses I'm making about their deck construction, just based off the fact they're playing Shaman. Sometimes they're right, you know. Sometimes.
I am not a morning person.
Next turn is Mukla's champion. I don't need more minions on my field. Is this strictly true? Yeah, that's strictly true. Well... Fuck it! You blow up your own shield to do nothing! Summon nothing! I'm gonna have to sacrifice a minion so that I can Mukla's in hero power. No. Or not.
Well,
from the void I come.
Oh my god, I had Mukla's and I clicked the wrong. I clicked the wrong one. While we're still gonna win, it's just not gonna feel as good as it could have. Twice to the face. Damn it.
You're in trouble now.
Rockbiter, Wind Fury. Come on, punish me for doing this.
There is a lot.
It was there. I fucked up. I clicked the wrong minion. The wrong minion.
You win this
one. Well played. Damn it! That would have been so good! Oh well. 2-0. What are we in? 17 minutes? 18 minutes? I'll definitely put this specific deck list in the description down below. I don't think I'm gonna alter this deck list before the end of the video. If I were, it would almost certainly be double Brewmasters out, double Soulfire in. Almost certainly. Because all of these things are kind of working in the way that I wanted them to, right? Mind Control Tech is taking over minions. The heals, right? Proof of concept being that Voodoo Doctor. Healing the opponent is definitely doing what I wanted. Mage. So you're going to be doing the same thing that the other guy was doing. I need early self-damage. Or at least an early minion that doesn't die to the ping. Yeah, that's some early self-damage right there. And I'm on first. Excellent. You know why it's probably more than 3? Because of the flame it. So that your opponent doesn't have to heal you on turn 1 in response to a flame imp. That's probably why it's more than 3 health that you need to be losing by. Otherwise, the flame imp opening would be absurd. Absurd. Like, really not okay. I now understand. I was a little angry about it previously, but now I understand. I wonder if they're gonna coin ping themselves. In which case, I just voodoo doctor them and love. Actually, no, I'd hero power. Mm-hmm. How are you gonna deal with this? Heal me is like the best way to do it. Explosive sheep. Oh, okay. To constantly deal with the size of the board. Makes sense. Just, I'm gonna leave this guy here to take more damage. Oh man. Okay, so this deck is gonna have a lot of board clear. Consistent, constant board clear. It looks like it's not even gonna battle me for the health. It's gonna battle me for card value and board clear. But when I get a free minion every turn, it's gonna be difficult to battle me for card value. So I'm losing by seven. So I've got to think of four as the magic number, because I've constantly been thinking of three, and then, you know, it doesn't work like that. So four is the magic number of difference.
I am ready.
Ping that. Makes sense. Man. The minions are not good so far. They're just not. I definitely want to summon... Okay, that's really good. Because that's hero power enhancer Meccano next turn. Nine difference. I can go face with one. So I give my opponent the chance to even up, but also I need to be in the game so that I can actually get on the board at some point. Coin freeze? Frostbolt? Okay, that makes sense. Is this person just playing like straight tempo mage? If so, that's kind of atrocious. Okay, that would explain a lot of the design stuff in their deck, I guess. Oh, I got that. That's cool. 11... This needs to die is the problem. Because by itself, it can actually provide board clear. Okay, so if my opponent wants to remove my board, they can do some things to remove my board. But if they remove the Void Caller, they put themselves in a horrible position. So doing that tells me they're not going to use AoE. Otherwise, it would have died to AoE anyway. Do you go for the... Okay, that makes sense.
Portals that makes online. Sense.
None of these have Wind Fury, right? No. Oh, okay, never mind, I have lethal. Whee! Well played. 3-0. 3 and Goose Egg. It's like four? No, not four. Three. I'm still enjoying this. Fuck it. We're still going. There was a... Oh god, who is it that said it? I feel bad that I don't remember this one because I really appreciated the comment. Just this is the loading music while I check the name of the person who left the comment. But on the last Tavern Brawl video that I did, there was a comment saying that I shouldn't worry about the length. I think it must have been Chuck Norris. That I shouldn't worry about the length of the episode, just how much I enjoy it. And if I enjoy it, I should just continue going. Where is this? Warrior is not okay. You have... Ooh. Chuck Norris. It was Chuck Norris. I was right. Yay! Warrior is not okay. You do have weapons, but you also have armor. So sure, you can take 4 damage to your own face by using a fiery war axe to kill this, but I take 3 damage to mine, so it evens up. Oh. Excellent. Power of warming. Okay, I'm just keeping an eye. Just keeping an eye on how much damage I have. I don't want to miss lethal on turn 3. I'm not gonna have it, but you know. Ogre Warmall? No, you're a legendary rank player. You don't have Ogre Warmall in your deck.
Let the pain speak to me.
Are you fucking seriously playing a patron? Like, are you that devoid of absolutely anything in your fucking head? That is a patron play. Inner Rage, Acolyte, that is a patron play. Wow. Why do you hate fun? I just have that question for you. What is it about fun that you so despise? What the fuck? You know, the one good thing about this mode is that you can't... Yep. Gnomish Inventor, this is a patron. The one good thing about this mode is that you just cannot get away with playing Face Hunter. You just can't do it. It's not possible.
My eyes are open.
Ugh. So the problem with this is that patron punishes you if you aren't at like 45 health. Yeah, kill a single minion. Now I'm above the health. I'm tempted to burn a power overwhelming to heal my opponent here. So they'd go back up to 30, then they'd use that, take 3 damage, but oh yeah, it's not even gonna get me the draw anyway. The death rattle on mine will trigger first, but it'll only trigger after Death Spite takes the hit. So I should heal up my opponent no matter what target they hit with their Death Spite. Unless, of course, they hit my face. Oh, well, if they hit my face, they're not going to be healing anyway. Sorry, they're not going to be dealing damage to themselves anyway, so I don't really need counterplay to that. Why? Why would you do this? This is a fun game mode. For fun. And you're playing a patron. Why? I just don't get it.
I wonder.
I seriously have difficulty understanding why someone would just... Oh, whatever. Whatever, just place that down. Anything but the flame imp being summoned from my hand is good. Hit that target, you get healed back to 30. Just killing minions that would have died if you passed it back to me. Oh, right, yeah. Doomsayer. My bad. Whatever. You know what's gonna be weird? Does this resolve first? Because this is at the start of my turn, but so is the other one. Yeah, your battle rages are drawing 1 card right now. Oh, I know what resolves first now. Damn it, my thirsty blade. So I'm gonna get all of my minions, but against patron, that doesn't matter, is the problem. It doesn't matter that you get minions. Because the patron can clear the board, kill your board. Yeah, that's it, we're done. Lame. Incredibly lame. Yeah, I forgot that it didn't have... I forgot that it has summoning sickness. It reminds me of, all of the ones where you would focus on, some sort of deck construction and then someone just plays Face Hunter, right? And that's why I really liked the idea of this one, because you can't play Face Hunter. The thing about Patron Warrior is you don't do damage at all. You do no damage the entire game. And then you just stall to one point, and then you do 48 points of damage to the base. And the worst part about it is there is nothing you can do about it. You need to hope they don't draw the right cards, or that their Emperor Thurasan is at the bottom of their deck. If neither of those things are true, they'll just win the game. Especially if your deck isn't built specifically to counter them. Which you can't rely on, unfortunately. Okay. Oh, that's really powerful. Having the tap, flame imp, tap. For turns 2 and 3. Because next turn I put myself 5 below my opponent, so they need to tap next turn. This forces them to. Oh, next turn I can Earthen Ring Voodoo Doctor them. That's going to be so good. This is an interesting element to the game. Patron Warrior is not. Mm-hmm. So now there's the 3 health difference. That's pretty annoying. Should probably get a silence in my deck to deal with something like that. So I kill that, I go back to 28. That's not okay. I can heal my opponent to 28 and then tap. That's also not okay. But it's at the start of my turn. But that doesn't matter if it's at the start of my turn or not. Alright, I'll go with this play. Kind of boring, but whatever. Gotta be done. Mountain Giant? Mountain Giant? They have the cards for it, I believe. Mountain Giant? Mountain Giant? Twilight Drake. Okay, they're playing Handlock. Wonder if it's worthwhile taking a silence into my deck just to deal with them. Handlocks, that is. There's a 6 health point difference. 6-point health difference, rather. Is vacuuming going on outside? Because, of course there is. Mm-hmm. So they have to sack that in order to break the health difference. Ooh, they're probably going to have a really big minion out of that. I don't know about this. Attack, Dread Infernal. No, I don't put myself lower in health. But do I even need to worry about putting myself lower in health? And if so, how much do I need to worry about it? Not that much. Not that much, I don't think. So now my Void Caller is just a 3-4, right? It doesn't summon any demon right now. But my opponent doesn't know that. There is some value in that. Okay. Weapon destruction in the deck is an interesting choice. Taunt is also an interesting choice. Alright, that's to prevent me doing the face burst kill you thing. Makes sense. If my opponent's going to pop their Void Caller, I want them to pop it on their turn, not mine. Because then they'll have Summoning Sickness on the demon they get. At least I now have something to summon from my Void Caller. Rothgard's pretty good.
I wonder.
I've extended, however, into Mind Control Tech territory. And the only one I don't... Like, the only one that's fine getting Mind Control Tech is the Enhanced Hermagana. This could be problematic. Dr. Boom's in the deck because, of course, Dr. Boom's in the deck. Why wouldn't Dr. Boom be in the deck? Attack there. So this is 7-7. I'm not that far off lethal, surprisingly. I'm tempted to just go all out. So that would be... Oh no, but what if they summon Mal'Ganis? If they summon Mal'Ganis, I've actually got a really good counterplay. Hang on. I'll take that. From the Void I come. So this is 7 damage with the power of Whelming. Double charge to the face. Drain Infernal. Yeah. Fuck, if only I'd drawn that first. That actually might be lethal at that point.
Drink with me, friend.
I'm uneasy about the state of the board. Right. They've just nullified my ability to draw this turn. But Morkless Champion Hero Power, Power of Warming is going to be really big. Mortal Cloth? Yep. So 4, 8, 8, 5. Is equal to 9, 8, 17, and 25. 25 points worth of damage if all of that goes through. Evidently, they are scared of all of that going through. I don't blame them. Okay, they don't want me to take the 7 damage by running in there. Oh, but they also don't want to leave the minion on the field. Nice. Nice play. Oh, that's pretty good. That is pretty good. Everything. Opponent summons nothing. Tap and turn. That was pretty good. Okay, opponent nullifies my minion. Again, they'll have to Hero Power this turn in order to prevent me from getting a minion. But if they Hero Power, they put themselves down to 23. I'm Mukla's Champion, tap. So then on board I'd have 4, 7, 7, 18... I'd have 21? 21 damage on board. And then I've got 7 in hand. So I've got 28 damage. Yeah, I've got 28 damage exactly.
So many possibilities.
The interesting things that have happened in this game totally make up for the bullshit patron warrior stuff that was going on. Yeah, ball play.
Well played.
Whee! Oh, it's not 28, it's 30. God damn it. Yeah, it's 30. I forgot about the Inspire buff. Inspire. Right. I forgot about the buff that that minion was going to get. Okay, we're at 40 fucking minutes. Alright. Alright, we'll do it again. We'll do it again. I'm still having fun with it. This episode is going to take 5,000 years to upload, which means that Fallout is probably either going to be late or not done today. God. At least I got Dark Souls up yesterday, so Dark Souls is going to be published 3 hours after this episode comes out, on the clock. I got on top of that. I just took some, like, personal days off doing everything in a row, and it kind of put me a lot behind the eight ball, so... Whoops. That's why there's been no Rocket League this week, either. Also because I wasn't able to organize... A recording time with Orbital Potato, but then again, I didn't really try to organize a time because I was taking personal time off. Welp. That's a pretty shitty opening hand. Pretty shitty opening hand. I'm glad I conceded to that patron. Just thinking about it, like, it really wouldn't have been fun to just watch, oh, hey, look, it's that minion, and then it's a Warsong Commander, and now there's a 5 whirlwind effects going on, of course there is. Yeah, that kind of thing. It just wouldn't have been fun. I'm tempted to tap. I don't need to. I'll put something on the board that can trade with that. These voodoo doctors have been doing fucking work. So this means that my opponent can't tap, right, and try and draw a card off the back of that. But then again, they wouldn't have been able to if they'd tried, because Earthen Ring. So I'm doing this thing where I've got a nice counterbalance of, I've got my own, my own strength into the way that this game is won, right? I've got my own ways to deal damage to my own health, but I've also got all of these counterplays to my opponent doing the same thing. While they haven't been incredibly important in all of the games, when they are important, they're really important. Damn, son. Not just a golden warlock, but a golden warlock with a golden flame imp. I wonder if their deck is all golden. We'll check when they play the coin.
Regret this.
Did you just... Did you just hit my face? Why? Why? So I hear the Earthring Fossil heal their face. They go back up to that. They trade. They go back down to 30. Okay, it's not even that bad for me. Why would you hit my face, though? That's, like, the best thing you could do for me. Yeah, I don't understand it. I really don't. I think they're trying to stop me from developing a really powerful minion so they would be able to put themselves... I don't know. That doesn't seem right. regardless. Maybe they're just so stuck in the standard kind of value of the game, like the standard things you really want to do, where you don't want to let your opponent trade a 2-1 into your 3-2 without attacking face, right? That's so ingrained. But maybe they had to do it. Okay. Coin tells me. Oh, well, we already knew they didn't have an all-gold deck, but coin confirms. Okay. So if you attack that, you will put yourself below the health threshold, but I can counter that by just tapping. So I can counter it by tapping, or by playing the Earthening Farseer, but tapping gives me the chance to draw into a 2. Evidently didn't happen, but you know, it could've. It could've. Next turn, I've got a 3 and a tap. Sounds pretty good. That's a Mulganis. Oh, that's a card! Okay, we're gonna have trouble now. Because now I'm really behind on the board. It's difficult for them this turn to put themselves in a position where I'm not gonna get the minion, which might be super important for me, because Enhancer Meccano plus Power Overwhelming... well, actually, no, only one of... because it will have Summoning Sickness. Damn. I've never really gotten a big minion out of this, right? That's kind of annoying. Is the difference in health equal to the minion you summon in mana cost? No, it's not. Because I summoned a wolf. And the difference in health has always been more than 3. So a wolf costs 2. Doesn't work out that way. Excuse me, am I dead? Am I dead? Did I die? I'm dead. Well played. Well fucking played, yeah. They knew what they wanted to do, and then they did it flawlessly. I'm going to 5 wins. We are not ending this without 5 wins. Yeah, they knew what they wanted to do. They wanted to have the ability to go, look, I'm demon, I've got all of this life loss. But at the same time, if you're going to try and play a life loss game, I'm just going to go face forever. So yeah, that 3 damage they did in the early game was correct. In retrospect? Weird. I mean, Hrothgar and Pitlord are really, really good curve plays.
Gul'dan versus Gul'dan.
Your soul shall be mine. Your soul shall suffer.
I'll keep Hrothgar. I don't want to be left out without an early play. I don't know if I can play Zombie Chow as an early play. They mulligan their entire hand, so they're definitely not confident with it. If they flame imp, it's Zombie Chow. Eh, it's still Zombie Chow. Tiny Knight of Evil is getting a lot more play in this mode than I expected. Feel free to tap. Does nothing right now.
This.
Probably gonna have to coin Pitlord next turn. If I've got a minion to sack this into, like if my opponent taps and summons a minion of any kind, and then I've got someone to throw this into, like that's really good for me. Is that really good for me? So, if I trade this in, I can go down to... I can take 8 damage to myself and go down to 22, but trading this in isn't even that great. Oh man, that's kind of annoying. I trade this in, they heal back up to 28, and then I coin Pitlord, I go back down to 25. I mean, I guess I still deny their draw, but that's kind of annoying. Yeah, I don't get my own. Damn it. I guess I'm relatively grateful to have Enhancer Meccano. I also might want to consider Defender of Argus, because you do constantly have minions on the board. And
that's okay.
So we can both lose 4 health if I attack that.
Feel my pain.
I don't have lethal.
Feel my pain. Feel my pain.
Both lose 4. And then I tap. Oh, double voodoo doctor. Amazing. Okay. This is really good for a number of reasons, but the biggest reason is that Inherzo Meccano now has 2 targets. 2 really small targets. Power overwhelming. Wind Fury. Oh, baby. Bane of Doom is not that good. Sure, you get a big minion, but Bane of Doom is still not that good.
Will be purged.
That's why. Do I even need to be the aggressor in this situation? Yeah, I kind of do. No, I don't. I can hold off. Whee!
I have no time for games.
Ooh, Sylvanas. Currently have 9 damage on the field. Okay, so if I kill this, that's not going to be able to pop itself, except for AoE effects.
Commence punchification.
Which is kind of annoying, because that means that I can't... I can't Dread Infernal because of it. Okay, fine, I'll just look this. And wait. It's kind of annoying because now I just open Mukla's up to Soulfire, Hellfire, yeah. A bunch of different removal spells. Oh, they're gonna go for my face. Interesting. Oh man, now I've got a fucking minion for them to steal. Oh, that's lame. That is so lame because there's nothing I can do against it right now. Because this destroys that, puts this down to 1 health, that trades into my Annoyatron, and then they get the Dread Infernal. Oh, that's the worst. I don't even want to fucking tap. That's so frustrating. Probably should have just held on to Mukla's. Yeah, almost certainly should have just held on to Mukla's. Yeah, now they get the minion. Pretty annoying. It's also quite annoying that I just... Where's the good minion?
Dead or alive?
Are they always small minions? Like, do you not actually get big minions with this? Because that's what it feels like. Oh, that would have been lethal on that draw, but they've still probably got lethal. It's just 3 damage. But yeah, so, I mean, like, Power Overwhelming, Soulfire, Hellfire, whatever. Fuck. Not Hellfire, because they've already used one and they just burned one. But, are you gated to a certain range of minions? Because none of the minions we've got have been stronger than 3, as far as I'm aware. That's surprising. Surprisingly not dead.
May my ancestors watch over them.
Hang on. So hang on. I have 11 damage, so I need to draw 4. I don't have the ability to draw 4. There's no 4 damage in my deck. Because I'm considering if I heal myself, I can tap for a turn. My opponent hasn't shown the ability to kind of like kill me outright, at least. Because I've got these double power overwhelmings in hand, so I have something here. Don't really know what. If they tap, that's hilarious.
We have many secrets.
Many secrets. 7/7. Oh, I have lethal. Oh, but it might kill me as well. That's interesting. And then depends on the bomb RNG as to who wins. Do I also lose? Nope! I just win! Yay! We stole the game and then won! Oh, okay, 5 wins. That's enough with this deck. I'm just gonna give it a little bit of a print screen right there so that I can put it in the description down below. My name has been Rhapsody. The name of the game has been Hearthstone Tavern Brawl. The name of the Tavern Brawl was, what was it again? Underdog rules. A random minion. It's not a random minion. Unless I'm missing something, it's not a random minion because I only ever got 3 cost and lower minions. I mean, 3 cost and lower minions is still okay, but it's not a random minion. Damn it. That's a shame, really. Anyway, my name has been Rhapsody, the name of the game, Hearthstone Tavern Brawl, I've already said all that stuff. There is a description down below with all the playlists for Tavern Brawl Arena, Adventures, and Ranked Past, Present, and Future, and hopefully, we'll see you next time.